Hello, I'm Deb Ashby and I'm a TAPS certified MOS accredited IT trainer. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to utilize named ranges to assist with navigation and formula maintenance. By using names in your spreadsheet, you can define a name for a cell range, function, constant, or table. A name is a meaningful shorthand that makes it easier to understand the purpose of a cell reference. It's good to get into the habit of naming items as you work. Once you adopt the practice of using names in your workbook, you can easily update, audit, and manage these names. Let's take a look at a practical example. Named ranges are a great way to identify cells, groups of cells, tables, and charts in Excel. I'm going to start by naming some ranges in my dataset. So I'm going to select my data in column A using Control Shift and down. And then in the name box just above, I'm going to give my data a name. So first underscore name. It's important to remember to press the Enter key to set your named range. And range names cannot contain any spaces. Let's name our range in column B. So we'll highlight and call it second underscore name. We'll do the same for column C and call this one date underscore hired. And finally, we'll do the same for column D, control shift down to highlight, and then type in the name, salary underscore info, and press enter. I can click the drop down arrow to see all of my named ranges in the list, making them really easy to select. I'm now going to format my entire data set as a table and give my table a name. So let's select an option. And in the table name box, I'm going to give my table a nice name that will make it easy to identify. I like to stick to a naming convention when I'm naming my tables. For example, all of my tables will begin with TBL. Let's double check to make sure that that's also been added to our name list, which I can see it has. And just to clean this up slightly, we will change our heading so that we can see the font. So why would you want to name ranges? Well, aside from being part of best practice, you can use names to help you navigate. So if I jump across to another spreadsheet, I can select a name range from the drop-down and it will jump me straight to that group of cells. Any names you set up can be managed through the Name Manager in the Defined Names group on the Formulas ribbon. This is where you can edit your named ranges. So if you select and click Edit, you can make some changes to it. And you can also delete any named ranges in here. So if you don't need them anymore, select and click on the Delete button. Named ranges can also make formulas quicker and easier to read. For example, if I want to sum the total of the salaries, I can type in equal sum, press the F3 key, which brings up all my named ranges, or alternatively type in the name of the range to select it. And there I have the result of the calculation, and it's easy for anyone looking at this spreadsheet to see that I'm summing the salary information just by looking at the name. Now I'm going to quickly delete the date hired named range and create it a slightly different way. Let's select the range. And this time in the Defined Names group, we're going to select Create from Selection and use the top row as the range name.